Hi, I'm Vashi Nedomansky, feature film editor and co-founder of Vashi Visuals. I'd like to take some time today and basically demystify color calibration and why it's so important for every kind of content creator. Doesn't matter what you're covering, be it a photographer, a graphic designer, a filmmaker, a vlogger, a documentarian. Everyone can benefit from a properly calibrated monitor. It's important to have a consistent and accurate color across all the projects that I work on, be them for me or for my clients. These factory settings on monitors are often exaggerated to push the contrast, push the colors, push the saturation, and give a unreal look, but that's not what we do at the end of the pipeline when we finish and deliver our final products. If you're serious about your creations and your storytelling and how you're gonna share these colors with the world, then I'd like to share with you four reasons why color calibration is essential to your workflow and why it'll give you wonderful results at the end so you can share your videos or anything else with the world. Number one, long-term accurate color reproduction. This is what the world will see, so you want it to be as accurate as possible. But sometimes monitors, both new and old, will sometimes have a color shift. That could be coming from the factory. It could be tinted towards magenta or green, and it's not accurate. It's not what you're seeing, and it's not the same as what you shot or created. The other thing that happens is oftentimes there'll be differences in brightness on the panel itself, on the monitor. Different areas could start fading or shifting, or the LEDs or whatever's inside can adjust or settle. So by recalibrating and calibrating properly out of the gate, you're getting the most accurate reproduction of your work, and then you can pass it on. Number two, color accuracy. I want my colors in the monitor to be perfect when I start a project. For me, I calibrate all my monitors monthly, and if I take a monitor to a new location, I'll recalibrate it on the other end. And oftentimes, if I just feel something is off, I'll just recalibrate. It doesn't take long, it gives you peace of mind, and then I can continue with my storytelling process. Number three, calibrate for accuracy and repeatable results. That's the key, that's the big one, because you want to have the same look or the same accurate look across all of your projects. So anything coming from you has your stamp on it. It's defined by your colors, it's defined by your brightness and your contrast. And the better accuracy and dialing in the look that you want that you can then repeat is critical, and that's why you calibrate. And number four, meet, repeat, and maintain professional standards. If you're delivering a 4K UHD HDR Blu-ray, or you're delivering a 709 video to YouTube, the same process is being applied in the pipeline to make accurate colors occur. And without a calibrated monitor, you honestly won't know what you're going to end up with. Or if it's for a higher level project, you won't pass QC because your colors will be either out of bounds, illegal, and you'll have to redo the process. So why not start at the beginning with a properly calibrated monitor so that you know anything you do downstream will be correct? The goal is to standardize your image output in the highest fidelity with the most accuracy possible. You gotta set yourself apart from other people. This is a technical skill that can be understood, grasped, practiced, and perfected. So having beautiful colors and having beautiful imagery and having people say, wow, your video looks amazing, that will set you apart from other people, and it's in your hands and it's something that you can do. I hope this demystifies why we would want to color calibrate, why it's important to our workflow, and why you should have color calibrated monitors on any project that you're doing. We're storytellers. We want our products and our videos and our imagery to look beautiful and resonate with people. And this is the first step on the pipeline to help you achieve that. Quick little teaser, in my next video, I'll be discussing a new Dell monitor that is capable of doing what the three behind me do. It's basically a black swan outlier. It's very magical, it's very nice, and it has some amazing features that, for me, I could go down to one monitor, which is saying something. Thank you for taking time and listening. I hope you learned a little bit, and we'll see you on the next one. Ciao for now.